fellowship divine. We feebly struggle, they in glory shine. Yes, all are one in thee, for all are thine. Ah, hallelujah, ah, hallelujah. And when the strife is fierce, the warfare long, steals on the ear the distant triumph song, and hearts are brave again and arms are strong. In the west, soon, soon the faithful warriors cometh rest. Sweet is the calm of paradise, the blessed. Ah, hallelujah, ah, hallelujah. But lo, their brave more glorious day, the saints triumphant rise in bright array. The King of glory passes on his way. Ah, hallelujah, ah, hallelujah. From earth's wide bound, ocean's farthest coast, through gates of pearl stream, in the countless host, singing to Father, Son, and Holy Ghost. Ah, hallelujah, ah, hallelujah.
Blessed are those who are persecuted for righteousness' sake, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed be God, Father, Son, and Holy Ghost. Blessed be God's kingdom, now and forever. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us prepare our hearts for the divine mysteries. Let us pray. Almighty God, to whom all hearts are open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hidden, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name, through Christ our Lord. Amen. Hear what our Lord Jesus Christ said. Hear, O Israel, the Lord our God, the Lord is one. You shall love the Lord your God with all your heart and with all your soul and with all your mind and with all your strength. This is the great and first commandment, and the second is like it. You shall love your neighbour as yourself. All the law and the prophets hang on these two commandments.
Lord, have mercy upon us, and write both these thy laws in our hearts, we beseech thee.
Lord, have mercy upon us.
us pray. Eternal God, you call us into your church as members of the body of Christ, and you mark us with the Holy Spirit as your pledge of redemption. Let our bodily life express what our faith draws us to believe, so that in communion with all your saints, we may live for the praise of your glory. We ask this through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Please be seated for the readings.
A reading from the book of the prophet Daniel, chapter 7, beginning at the first verse. In the year of King Belshazzar of Babylon, Daniel had a dream and visions of his head as he lay in his bed. Then he wrote down the dream. I, Daniel, saw in my vision by night the four winds of heaven stirring up the great sea. And four great beasts came up out of the sea, different from one another. As for me, Daniel, my spirit was troubled within me, and the visions of my head terrified me. I approached one of the attendants to ask him the truth concerning all of this. So he said that he would disclose to me the interpretation of the matter. As for these great four beasts, four kings shall arise out of the earth, but the holy ones of the Most High shall receive the kingdom and possess the kingdom forever, forever and ever. Hear the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
A reading of Psalm 149. The response is, sound praises to the Lord, all the earth.
Sound praises to the Lord, all the earth.
O praise the Lord and sing to the Lord a new song. O praise him in the assembly of the faithful. Let Israel rejoice in him that made him. Let the children of Zion be joyful in their king. Let them praise him in the dance. Let them sing his praise with timbrel and with harp. For the Lord takes delight in his people. He adorns the meek with his salvation.
Sound praises to the Lord, all the earth.
Let his faithful ones exult in his glory. Let them sing for joy upon their beds. Let the high praises of God be in their mouths, and a two-edged sword in their hands, to execute vengeance on the nations and chastisement upon the peoples, to bind their kings in chains, and their nobles with fetters of iron, to visit upon them the judgment that is decreed. Such honour belongs to all his faithful servants. Praise the Lord.
Sound praises to the Lord, all the earth.
Glorious and redeeming God, give us hearts to praise you all our days and wills to reject the world's deceits, that we may bind the evils of our age and proclaim the good news of salvation in Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
A reading from Paul's letter to the Ephesians, chapter 1, beginning at the 11th verse. In Christ we have also obtained an inheritance, having been destined according to the purpose of him, who accomplishes all things according to his counsel and will, so that we, who were the first to set our hope on Christ, might live for the praise of his glory. In him you also, when you had heard the word of truth, the gospel of your salvation, and had believed in him, were marked with the seal of the promised Holy Spirit. This is the pledge of our inheritance towards redemption as God's own people, to the praise of his glory. I have heard of your faith in the Lord Jesus and your love toward all the saints, and for this reason I do not cease to give thanks for you as I remember you in my prayers, that the God of our Lord Jesus Christ, the Father of glory, may give you a spirit of wisdom and revelation as you come to know him, so that with the eyes of your heart enlightened, you may perceive what is the hope to which he has called you. What are the riches of his glorious inheritance among the saints, and what is the immeasurable greatness of his power for us who believe, according to the working of his great power? God put this power to work in Christ when he raised him from the dead and seated at his right hand in the heavenly places, far above all rule and authority and power and dominion, and above every name that is named, not only in this age, but also in the age to come. And he has put all things under his feet and has made him the head over all things for the church, which is his body, the fullness of him who fills all in all. Hear the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. We stand to sing our gradual hymn, Ye Watchers and Ye Holy Ones.
Ye watchers and
Then Jesus looked up at his disciples and said, "Blessed are you who are poor, for yours is the kingdom of God. Blessed are you who are hungry now, for you will be filled. Blessed are you who weep now, for you will laugh. Blessed are you when people hate you and when they exclude you, revile you and defame you on account of the Son of Man on that day and leap for joy. For surely your reward is great in heaven, and for that is how their ancestors treated the prophets. But woe to you who are rich, for you have received your consolation. Woe to you who are full now, for you will be hungry. Woe to you who are laughing now, for you will mourn and weep. Woe to you when all speak well of you, for that is how their ancestors treated the false prophets. But I say to you who are listening, love your enemies, do good to those who hate you. Bless those who curse you, pray for those who mistreat you. If one strikes you on the cheek, offer the other also. And from anyone who takes away your coat, do not withhold even your shirt. Give to everyone who asks of you, and if anyone takes away what is yours, do not ask for it back again. Do to others as you would have them do to you." This is the gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
May I speak in the name of God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. Please have a seat. When I was studying theology at university, I would frequent Coorong for textbooks, commentaries, and the like, because when you study in Melbourne University, where the library is, and you live in Newcastle, there's a bit of a distance issue going on there. And one week, when I went to have a look at what they had, I, as usual, would talk to the staff, and will add that I still do when I pop in to visit them and get some bits and pieces. And there used to be this young man who had come from an Islamic household who became a Christian. And this week that I went to go get some textbooks and order some bits and pieces, because they never seemed to have the books I need right there and then, I'd always have to order them in. It was a whole thing. But I'd order in the books. We got talking about the saints. And because he had come from a non-Christian house and was attending a Baptist church, he didn't really understand what I meant when I was talking about the saints. Which, for me as an Anglican, was a bit foreign, as many of our churches are named after them. They're named after the saints. And we're probably an oddity that is not where most are. We celebrate their feast days and even have books written about them, such as Acts and Monuments, which was written in 1563 by the Reverend John Fox. Its common name is Fox's Books of Martyrs, and within it, it has the lives of many English saints and martyrs of the time and beforehand. We also have things like the Ecclesiastical History of the English People, which was written by a saint called the Venerable Bede, who is recognized across Anglicanism, Roman Catholicism, and Eastern Orthodoxy. And in his book, The Ecclesiastical History of the English People, which was written in 731, is another great example of the long shared history of saints and the Anglican Church, and also with the wider Christian or one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. And as I talked to this young man, he asked me about a particular person who had been in his parish, and this person had recently died. And he asked me if this person would be a saint in heaven, which led to a complex yes and no. Earlier this week, we celebrated part of the great Triduum of Death. Triduum just means 3 days, which is All Hallows Eve, or commonly known as Halloween, on the 31st of October. And many of you may remember when we did the haunted house here in the church, well, in the hall, where we celebrate the lives of saints and those who had died for their faith. It was a good day. We gave away so much candy and lots of pocket gospels. But it was an event to show people the traditions of All Hallows Eve, or Halloween as it's commonly called today. Then we celebrated on Wednesday night the Feast of All Souls, where we remember those who have been Christians in their lives, but we don't know if they are yet in the full presence of God. And then we were meant to have today, which is All Saints, we transpose, we move the feast to today, but is normally celebrated on the 1st of November, which was Tuesday. So you have All Hallows Eve, All Saints, All Souls. Actually, you should have gone backwards because you're on my other side. But it is commonly called All Saints, but its traditional name is All Hallows, which is just the Old English word for holy or saint. So that's why we have All Hallows Eve and Hallows Eve and All Souls. These three great days are referred to as the period of All Hallowtide, or All Saints, All Holy Time. A time to remember those who have come before us, those who will come after us, and that we all must die. But what is the difference between what we may refer to as those capital S saints and the saints, the lowercase saints, that we experience every day in our lives? Because we are all called to be saints, to be holy in our lives as Christians. But what causes it to become a title? Maybe a way to give light to this idea is that I have the name Zeb, right? You all know me as Zeb, but like all people, I have a title. So before I was ordained, I was Mr. or Master. That's where the MR comes from. Or if I was a woman, Miss. Or if married, Mrs. But when I was ordained, my title became the Reverend. I'm still the same Zeb in many ways. However, the church has decided that my new first name is The. Hello, I'm The. But all that aside, the church has set me aside through the laying on of hands, which dates back to Jesus himself, through the bishops that we have, and recognizes the ontological, which just is a fancy word for internal change, that comes with that process of laying on of hands. So in the same way, there are saints we recognize in our lives, the everyday saints that we engage with and act with, that we know and see something that reflects the holiness of Jesus in their lives, right? We see that aspect of Christ. But there are people who are recognized not just by ourselves, but by the church universal for their likeness and closeness to God, to Jesus. Usually these people have made great impacts on the church, live lives that by the end have exemplified God. Good note though is that it doesn't always mean they always started out great. They can come in very varied early life stages, but by the end of their life they have exemplified who God is and have seen people's lives changed through their ministry. Such an example is Saint Lucian Tapadi, one of the New Guinea martyrs who we celebrate on the 2nd of September, who was murdered at the hands of, he was an indigenous man of Papua New Guinea, and he was murdered at the hands of other locals who were not Christian. His impact saw others come to faith, including the man who killed him, seeing churches built in his memory, such as St. Lucian's Six Mile in Port Moresby. Or another example from our very own diocese is St. James Noble, who we celebrate on the 25th of November, from this very diocese itself, from St. Luke's at Scone, who brought justice to the Aboriginal massacre near Forest River. But these two are some of the many saints we celebrate in the year of the church. But there are less days in the year than there are saints. Definitely more than 365 saints to celebrate. So what does that mean for those who are not included in the lectionary? We have today, All Saints. This day is to remember and celebrate the saints that have lived lives that do not have their own day. We know from the scriptures that only one person can be worshipped. Who is that? That's God, isn't it? Only God, the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit can be worshipped. So today is about recognizing the one, the God, who transformed these people's lives. When we celebrate these people, we do not pray to them, just as we do not worship the cross itself. Rather, the God, the person, Jesus, that they represent. It's a bit like the Ark of the Covenant from Exodus 25, and it's laden with gold and cherubim on the throne, but they don't worship it. It gets all the pomp and ceremony, but they do not worship the Ark of the Covenant. Or maybe the bronze serpent of Numbers 21, where Moses lifts up the bronze serpent and those who gaze upon it are healed. These things stand as things not to be worshipped, but rather items that point us back to the one who created, who changed and made holy these people. We as a church are not a dead faith. If we're a dead faith, let's close up tomorrow and I'll go to the beach on Sundays. But we are a living faith that is calling people to transformation of life. And likewise, we do not believe that those who have come before us are dead. Rather, they are, like those who die as lower S saints, will be made fully alive in Christ, who is all our life. In the book of Revelation, I always enjoy Revelation. It's a great book, a lot of crazy things going on in there. If you're not in Bible study, let me encourage you that we're going to be doing Revelation soon, and we'll unpack it more. But I want to pull out some themes that come from that book. For example, in the book of Revelation, we see images of the saints, worshipping of God, singing hymns, playing instruments. Interesting enough, asking Jesus to avenge their martyrdom and offering prayers for the saints on earth. This is seen at, if you want to look up these verses, Revelation 4:10, 5, 8, and 6, 9 to 11. Capital S saints and lowercase s saints are seen within the scriptures, and that is why we give thanks for them. The scriptures tell us that they are able to pray for us, is another example. Let me give you the passage. Revelation 6 says, have a listen. When he broke the fifth seal, I saw under the altar the souls of those who had been slaughtered for the word of God and for the testimony they had given. Now that's a challenge. Imagine being killed, which we've talked about before, for your testimony. They cried out with a loud voice, Sovereign Lord, holy and true, how long will it be before you judge and avenge our blood on the inhabitants of the earth? We see the saints praying to God in heaven, asking for his intercession. They were each given a white robe and told to rest a little longer until the number would be complete, both of their fellow servants and of their brothers and sisters who soon were to be killed as they themselves had been killed. Those who live as lowercase s saints here on earth have the support of those capital S saints in heaven. We see that right there in Revelation. They offer their prayers to God, Sovereign Lord, to God, to Jesus, who is the only mediator between God and humanity. Because it is only by the death and resurrection of Christ that we are able to be saved. It is only Christ that can make us holy, make us lower and capital S saints. And it is by Christ's blood that we are made clean. Now, I do like the BCP. That's our sort of gold standard for worship. It's our gold bullion. It's worth its weight in gold. And the BCP has the prayer of humble access that we pray every Sunday. But in the old translation, I want to draw out these words that unfortunately did not make it into the new revision, but I still love nonetheless. That our sinful bodies may be made clean by his body and our souls washed through his most precious blood. We are all saints, the church militant, the living body of Christ here on earth, and we all have one thing in common, the need for Jesus. We all are called to a life of holiness. We are all called to pray for each other. We are all called into eternal life. Paul appealed to his readers to pray for him in Romans 15. The saints pray for us as well in his nearer presence in Revelation 6, 9 to 11. And James tells us to pray for one another because the prayer of the righteous are powerful. And that's in James 5, 16. We are called to be the people of God, and that is a good thing, a powerful thing, because God calls all of us from that state of separation into his fullness. God rejects no one. It's us who reject him. Every sinner has a past and every saint has a future. So then that raises the question, what then is your future with Christ look like? Will it be one where you fight the good fight, finish the race and keep the faith? Or is it one where you'll be lost on the way? Christ is calling you into something amazing in his church. And I celebrate that we all are called to a ministry and vocation. If you want to explore that more, let's go for coffee. Or if you don't want coffee, you can have a cup of tea. Or if you don't want a cup of tea, we'll have some water. And if you don't want that even, we'll have nothing. But just don't feed me. I don't need more food on my waistline. But let's talk. How can we empower you to be God's hands and feet in the world? Because you are the lifeblood of Christ in the world, his saints, his holy people. All you have to do to take that on is give everything to him, to place it at the foot of the cross, which is that representation of the God who gave everything for you. And in him giving everything for you, all he wants to do is make you holy if you let him. Amen.
By whom all things were made, who for us
judge both the quick and the dead, whose kingdom shall have no end. And I believe in the Holy Ghost, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceedeth from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son together is worshipped and glorified, who spake by the prophets. And I believe one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. I acknowledge one baptism for the remission of sins, and I look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Please sit or kneel as able as we pray for the world and for the church.
Let us pray to God, whose saints have witnessed his glory. May your church, built on the foundation of the saints, be faithful to the teaching of Jesus, so that in all her life she may reveal his likeness. Let our prayers be united with the praise of the blessed in heaven. Give to the church grace to shine as a light in the world and show forth the glory of her Lord. Bless her ministers with power to preach the gospel of salvation. Gather strength and perseverance to all Christian missionaries, evangelists, and teachers. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
We pray for the world that is so often deaf to the only teaching that can bring true joy. Grant to this generation the spirit that inspired the saints, that all may walk in way of righteousness. Hasten the time when the earth shall be filled with the knowledge of the Lord. Bring the light of truth to all in positions of authority and influence, that they may lead those they govern into the right way. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Teach us to recognize the holiness of other people. Give to us, our families and friends, grace to live as Jesus taught his disciples. Help us so to live that our deeds shall be worthy of the faith which we hold in our community. Bless all teachers and those who can be a guide to others. Lord, in your mercy. Lord, have mercy on those who are in great tribulation, persecuted for the sake of gospel. Bring relief in their distress and the assurance of your blessing for all who are steadfast in faith. We pray for all who suffer for their witness to the faith, for missionaries in hostile countries, for converts who are persecuted by their communities. Have mercy on those who have fallen away, and restore in them in the confidence of their first love. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Grant to the faithful departed a share in the inheritance of the saints, as we offer our prayers for them. May their heavenly prayers avail for us as we continue on our early pilgrimage. Bring us at last with Mary, Mother our Lord, Saint Joseph, her spouse, and all the saints in the same blessedness. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer. God, the fountain of all holiness, you gave many talents to your saints on earth, and now in heaven you crown them with one glory. Let their fellowship inspire your people, so that each of us in our vocation as Christians may lead a life worthy of our calling. We ask this through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Amen. Almighty God, you have promised to hear our prayers. Grant that what we have asked in faith, we may by your grace receive through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Amen. Hear what comfortable words our Saviour Christ said to all who truly turn to him. Come to me, all you who are weary and are carrying heavy burdens, and I will give you rest. For God so loved the world that he gave his only Son, so that everyone who believes in him may not perish, but may have eternal life. Hear also what St. Paul said, the saying is sure and worthy of full acceptance, that Christ Jesus came into the world to save sinners. Hear also what St. John said, "But if anyone does sin, we have an advocate with the Father, Jesus Christ the righteous, and he is the atoning sacrifice for our sins." Let us pray. We do not presume to come to your table, merciful Lord, trusting in our own righteousness, but in your manifold and great mercies. We are not worthy so much as to gather up crumbs under your table, but you are the same, Lord, whose nature is always to have mercy. Grant us, therefore, gracious Lord, so to eat the flesh of your dear Son, Jesus Christ, and to drink his blood, that we may evermore dwell in him and he in us. Amen. The saints were faithful unto death and now dwell in the heavenly kingdom forever. Let us then run our race, laying aside every weight and bringing our sins to the Lord in penitence and faith. Merciful God, our Maker and our Judge, we have sinned against you in thought, word, and deed, and in what we have failed to do. We have not loved you with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbours as ourselves. We repent and are sorry for all our sins. Father, forgive us. Strengthen us to love and obey you in newness of life, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Almighty God, who has promised forgiveness to all who turn to him in faith, pardon you and set you free from all your sins, strengthen you in all goodness, and keep you in eternal life, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Would you please stand? We are the body of Christ. The peace of the Lord be always with you. We share God's peace together with those who are here and those who join us online. Peace, Talis. Peace, Asha. Peace, Paulie. Brothers and sisters, let me remind you that the prophet Tobit said, "If you have many possessions, make your gift from them in proportion. If you do not be afraid to give according to the little you have, so you will be laying up good treasure for yourself against the day of necessity." Our offertory hymn is, "As We Gather at Your Table." Thank you. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have this bread to offer, which earth has given and human hands have made. Can you say tell us? It will become for us the bread of life. Blessed be God forever. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have this wine to offer, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become our spiritual drink. Blessed be God forever. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have this gift of our labour. Accept and use this offering for your glory and for the service of your kingdom. Blessed be God forever. God, our host, at whose table we are made one, grant that like all your saints we may run our earthly course with faith and have eternal communion with them in your kingdom. We ask this through Jesus Christ our Lord.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always here and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Today you gather your church to keep the festival of your holy city, that heavenly Jerusalem, which is our mother, within her walls the saints, our brothers and sisters, crown you with the praise for all eternity. Today, then we hasten with eager steps as pilgrims who walk by faith, rejoicing in the glory you have given to these members of your church, whose radiance also you display before us to strengthen and inspire our weaknesses here on earth. Therefore, with angels and archangels, and with all the company of heaven, we proclaim your great and glorious name, forever praising you and singing. Holy, holy, holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of thy glory. Glory be to thee, O Lord Most High. Blessed is he who cometh in the name of the Lord.
Gracious God, all creation rightly gives you praise. All life, all holiness comes from you through your Son, Jesus Christ our Lord, whom you sent to share our human nature, to live and die as one of us, to reconcile us to you, the God and Father of all. Hear us, merciful Lord, through Christ accept our sacrifice of praise, and by the power of your word and Holy Spirit, sanctify this bread and wine, that we who share in this holy sacrament may be partakers of Christ's body and blood, who, when his hour had come on the night before he went up to the cross to make a full atonement for the sins of the whole world, offering once for all his one sacrifice of himself, took bread and gave you thanks. He broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take, eat. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." In the same way, after supper, he took the cup and gave you thanks. He gave it to them, saying, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you drink it, in remembrance of me." mystery of faith. We proclaim thy death, O Lord, and profess thy resurrection until thou come again. Therefore, in obedience to his command, we celebrate, commemorate and celebrate his saving passion and death, his mighty resurrection and ascension into heaven, and we eagerly await his coming again in glory. We thank you that by your grace alone you have accepted us in Christ, and here we offer you a spiritual sacrifice, holy and acceptable in your sight. Through Christ receive this duty and our duty and service, and grant that we who eat and drink these holy gifts may by your Holy Spirit be one body in Christ and serve you in unity and peace. Gracious God, renew the life of your church. Remember Peter, our bishop, and all ministers who break and share the living bread among us. Remember those broken in body or spirit. Give them peace in the glorious wounds by which we have been healed. In your grace and mercy, bring us to the joy of your eternal kingdom with all the company of the redeemed. May we praise you in union with them and give you glory through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him, with him, and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, gracious Father, forever and ever. Saviour Christ has commanded and taught us, we are bold to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from the power and the glory forever and ever. Amen.
We break this bread to share in the body of Christ. We who are many are one body, for we all share in the one bread. God who takes away the sins of the world, happy are those who are called to his supper. Lord, I am not worthy to receive you, but only say the word, and I shall be healed. Christ, our Passover, is sacrificed for us. Therefore, let us keep the feast. Come, let us take this holy sacrament of the body and blood of Christ, in remembrance that he died for us, and feed on him in our hearts by faith with thanksgiving. Christ, keep you in eternal life. The blood of Christ, keep you in eternal life. Jesus said to the disciples, "Go into all the world and proclaim the good news to the whole creation." Let us pray. God, our provider, you give the one bread and the one cup to feed us, and one strong hope to sustain us. Make us one with all your saints in the fullness of Christ's body, so that we may rise again to glory with him who is Lord forever and ever. Father, we offer ourselves to you as a living sacrifice through Jesus Christ, send us out in the power of your Spirit to live and work to your praise and glory. Great to see you all. I'm ready for a coffee. It'll be my third. and I had a big can of Monster energy drink to get my day started, so I'm looking forward to another coffee. My heart's going to explode at one point and I'll just collapse. Call the ambulance, please, if that happens. So that's first up, so I'll see you over for a coffee at the hall. Second is Spring Fair is this Saturday. If you can help out, we're setting up from Friday afternoon about 12-ish till when we're done. And then if you want to come and help on the day, I'm going to be here from probably about 7 a.m. If you want to help out, probably like no later than 8, if you want to come help, just so I can tell you like what we need to do and give out like money bags and all that sort of guff, all that sort of stuff as well. It's going to be a great day. It'll be lots of fun. Please come. Tell your friends. It's going to be wonderful. So we're doing that. Third, is Trivia raised $750. Thank you for those who came to Trivia. It was a great night. We'll do it again on the 27th of January. So it'll be a good fun night again. Invite your friends. You know that I can run a good Trivia night now. It's not boring. Gosh, like unlike normal church Trivia that can be a bit sometimes. So going to be good fun. And I think that's, oh yes, there's raffle tickets up the back if you want some. They're still $2. We're hoping to sell all of them by Spring Fair. For, you know, the prizes, a Nintendo Switch, expensive sunglasses, gift cards, all that sort of stuff. It's a good set of prizes. And finally, actually, I think that's it. Is there anything else I forgot? No. Oh, yes. Joshua's birthday on Friday. Joshua, that's right. Your dad was telling me I'm running on like zero sleep. It's great. Joshua, would you like a birthday blessing? All right, come on up. We'll give you one. Wonderful. I'll see you over at the hall for some coffee. I'll be there. Would you please stand for the blessing? May Christ, who makes saints of sinners, who has transformed those we remember today, rise and strengthen you, that you may transform the world. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be upon you and remain with you always. Amen. Amen. Go in peace to love and serve the Lord. In the name of Christ. Amen. And this is on my funeral list, Asher, one of my favorites. Good. When my heart explodes and I collapse in the middle of church, just start playing this. It'll be great. Someone else can call the ambulance. Off we go. Ye who own the faith of Jesus. Huh? No, it's a